Good morning, everyone. Answer for the previous assignment.
What is this about?
Yes, this is about an interesting fact of reflection, that is multiple reflection by two mirrors. Have you ever noticed your image between two parallel mirrors? You would have seen number of images. For example, in saloons, beauty parlors, and even trial rooms of textile shops. That is multiple reflection. How does this number of images form? The image formed by one mirror acts as an object for the other mirror. The same way, when the object is placed in between two mirrors which are kept at an angle, the angle we can call theta. You can notice not only two images, but some additional images will also form. There is a small formula for calculating the number of images. Number of images is equal to 360 degree by theta minus 1. We will see how to calculate this. 490 degree. 360 by 90 minus 1. Can cancel this. And with the 9 table, 4 9s are 36, 4 minus 1, 3 images can form for 90 degree. Then for 60 degree, 60 minus 1, 1 6 is 6, 6 6 are 36, isn't it? 6 minus 1, 5 images can be formed. Next with 45 degree, 360 by 45 minus 1, you can directly cut with 45 table. I think it's 8 times. 8 minus 1 is equal to 7 images can be formed for 45 degree. Then for 36 degree, it's for 10 times, no. So 10 minus 1, 9 images can be form. Do you notice this? As the angle get decreased, the number of images get increased. Lesser the angle between the two mirrors, greater will be the
number of images.
Okay, now what would happen when the mirrors are at parallel, that is without angle? Angle zero. An infinite number of images can be seen. The images become smaller and fainter as the distance from the mirror increases.
Let's see a small activity to have a better understanding of this multiple reflection.
Multiple images. When you go for a haircut, how do you check that the hairstylist has done the right styling for you, as we cannot see at our back? Our hairdresser puts a mirror at the back side of our head, and then we are able to see the hairstyle in the mirror which is in front of us. Let us understand this with the help of an activity. Take two plain mirrors. Label one as A and the other as B. Keep them at the angle of 90 degrees. Now place a coin in between the mirror. What do you observe? We observe three images of the coin. How are images formed? Actually, one image in one of the mirror acts as the object for another mirror. So we get two images. Also, images of both mirrors are also seen in each other, and hence we are able to see three images. This is called multiple image formation or multiple reflections. Now we come back to our examples. The mirror put at the back of our hair forms the image of our hair, which acts like an object for the mirror kept in front, and we could see one more image in the front mirror. If we change the angle between the two mirrors, we obtain different number of images. There is a formula for obtaining multiple images depending on the angle between the two plane mirrors, denoted by theta. Number of images is equal to 360 degrees upon theta minus 1. It means, if angle theta is equal to 180 degrees, then number of images will be equal to 1. If the angle is 60 degrees, then the number of images will be equal to 5.
It's time for your assignment. Thank you.